really excited with our kids' effort tonight. You know, Greg's got a good team. You know, they're putting some pieces together. But I thought, especially, I mean, we got off to a really bad start. We're down 13, 14, nothing. But then we're only down 15 at halftime. And that's a great effort by our kids, what I expect from them. We will have better shooting days. And when we do, we'll be able to beat anybody in the country at our level, as long as we put in the effort. Defensively and rebound the ball. We only give up 3 offensive rebounds in the first half, which was huge. The 2 things I talked about before the game were turnovers, limiting turnovers, and rebounding the ball. And we had 8 at halftime, which is a few too many, but not overly bad. We only give up 3 offensive rebounds, and that's what we got to do. Second half, we didn't do those things, and it got away from us a little bit. But happy for the opportunity to play in this game. Incredibly honored to be in a game where you're talking about Jim Shaw and Royce Waltman as a part of the festivities, because those are 2 of the best people and the best coaches I've ever met. So just an incredible experience.
Yeah, it was. I was just really excited to come back and play Holman Center one last time. I got to play here in high school for the North-South game. I got to play here 2 years ago against ISU. It's always been a special place for me, going to see ISU play growing up. I had a cousin who played here at ISU as well. I was just really grateful for the opportunity once again. I'm really excited for this year. I think we got a really great group of guys, and I think we're gonna make a pretty deep run for our conference. So,
questions.
How tough was it, Rusty? That it was similar to the start 2 years ago from the shooting perspective. It didn't get out of hand like it did 2 years ago. But how tough is it to try to stay in this game when those shots just weren't falling for you early?
Well, every timeout we had, I kept saying the same thing. We are getting the shots that we need to get, and that's all I can ask. And I think that over the course of the season, we'll make those, and we'll be fine. As a coach, you're frustrated, but when you're getting good shots, that frustration is a different kind of frustration. And I think my frustration was just really feeling for the kids that they're getting good looks and not making them, more so than, hey, we're just not executing what we're supposed to be doing. I thought we executed well, got good shots, we just didn't make enough of them. But like I said, we did bounce back in that sort of last half to 2/3 of the first half and played, you know, toe-to-toe with them, which is exciting. We could have ducked our heads and felt sorry for ourselves. We weren't making shots and we got behind big early. We didn't. We bounced back and played a good, you know, last 2/3 of the first half.
Coach, I know everybody knows about ISU's guards with Barnes and Key, but Rickman inside and Thomas, especially Rickman, very aggressive. What did you? I know they had the size on you a little bit, but what did you think of the way that they were able to dominate?
I mean, Rickman is just such a big human being down there, and he does a great job of being patient in the post. And you know, when you got Barnes out there and you got Key driving the ball, that's going to create space for him inside. And if he can play really well for them this year, I think that'll be a huge lift for ISU. You know, getting that inside play. And Thomas is just so long and athletic that for our guys, that's tough for them to deal with. You know, I told Ruggi on the one drive, he had a great play, drives the ball. You know, it gets thrown off the backboard at a high velocity. And I said, hey, that's great, because we don't have guys like that in our league. You're going to get to the basket and score, because we don't have guys that can block shots like that. But, you know, those guys are really good players. And the more they develop and as the year goes along, they're going to really help them win games this year.
Charlie, if it's frustrating from a coach's perspective to see shots not fall, I imagine from a player perspective it's doubly, triply so. How hard was it for you guys to try to work through that period at the beginning of the game? And like Rusty said, you guys played much better after that. But knowing that, you know, you want to come out and start well, how frustrating was that for you guys today?
Yeah, it's tough at first. You always want to see your shots falling, especially, you know, coming in a good environment like this. But just stay confident in ourselves. I mean, we know we can make those shots. We know they're going to fall. Averages always play out eventually. So, I mean, we just kept working hard, and, you know, whatever the result was, we're happy. But we know we got a long season ahead of us. Shots are going to fall. I'm not too worried.
What do you think you learned about your team today, especially since you got, you know, another couple weeks before you play for real? What was the biggest thing that comes out of this?
I think it shows that we're good, you know, fighting through adversity. You know, starting down, you know, double digits to nothing at the beginning of the game, coming back, fighting, I mean, keeping a close game for the majority of the game. I think we really battled hard, and I think we're a tough team to defeat over the course of the year.
Any other questions? Gentlemen, thank you. Best of luck to you.
Thanks, guys.